All right, guys, we're back here in Yakima, Washington with Adolfo. And an update. How you been, Adolfo?
I've been maintaining.
Where you been at, bro, since the last time I interviewed you?
I went to the hospital, did a respite.
They did what?
I went to the hospital, then to respite.
What's that, bro?
Respite is like a 7-day rest or 21-day rest or something like that for those who come out of the hospital or something like that.
Have you had any family or friends that checked up on you when you went to the hospital?
Yeah, I had somebody come visit me, a couple people.
What's
that? I had a couple people come visit me.
That's good, bro. That's good. What all have you been up to since the last time I saw you, bro, besides that?
Just trying to get my meds right, try to get my housing again, permanent again, and just keep my foot right.
You mentioned, bro, since the last time that we spoke, you said that something happened that you had to get amputated on your foot even more, that it wasn't gangrene this time or frostbite. What was it?
I don't know. It's something to do with my blood.
With your blood, huh?
Like a, I don't know what it is. I don't know. I didn't
talk. What they say happens?
They were just supposed to clean it, and then they're supposed to clean. I thought they were gonna clean this the right foot, but then they end up. And then amputate. No, I thought they were gonna clean my left foot and then amputate my right foot, but they kept my right foot and ended up amputating my left foot.
What's like the nicest thing that people have done for you, bro? An average person that like sees you on the side of the road, what's the nicest thing that they've done?
You got a hug.
What's that?
A hug.
Yeah,
for somebody who's completely strange.
I know last time you mentioned that a little kid helped you with something, right?
Right here.
Really?
Some yesterday gave me like $9, and he left and he came back and goes, you know, I gave you that money to eat.
That's good.
Yeah.
That's good.
Yeah, it was a good deed.
And it's good for adults to teach that to our kids, you know?
Yeah.
To help out.
Cuando puedan, you know what I'm
saying? Yeah, when you can, for sure. So yeah, bro, before the video you mentioned that in order to do the video that you had to do a quick fix. What'd you mean by that?
Not a quick fix. I need to kill my pain.
You had to cure your pain.
Yeah, I had to take my medication.
What medication was it?
This is my pain medicine.
What kind of pain medication do you have to take for all the pain that you go through, brother?
It's a narcotic.
Yeah. Have you done blues or meds or anything?
I ain't talking about that. Nah, I ain't talking about that.
What's that?
I ain't talking about that. I've been smoking a lot of weed lately.
A lot of weed, huh?
Yeah, more chronic.
Yeah, what all have you seen out here, bro?
I just got back out here, so I've been on the Nazis area for a while, so I haven't been on this side for a while. Yeah.
What's your favorite spot to post up at in Yakima?
Yakima? Just Yakima.
Anywhere
in Yakima? Yeah.
Because I've seen you everywhere, bro. When I first met you, you were over there by Fiesta Foods, by over there.
Yeah, I remember that. Yeah.
Where do you feel is the area that people are the most generous?
I don't know. I don't put no weight in that, bro. It has to do with people's hearts, you know what I mean?
For sure.
Whatever they could, you know, whatever they want to share.
For sure, bro.
I mean, like, I think this is generous, you know what I mean?
What's that?
The soda. For sure. Whatever you can help me with later.
Well, I mean, like we spoke, you know, like, you don't have to give your time to me and to the viewers. But you choose to, and I appreciate that, man. Even if it is for a soda or for whatever, you know, it's kind of you, bro. Like, before, when you first met me, you weren't for it, you know?
Yeah, I was like,
you're like, what's this guy, you know?
Yeah, I'm still kind of weird about it. It's still kind of weird about it, because I don't like the camera.
A lot of people are like that, you know?
Yeah.
Where they're, like, at first, they're kind of tripped out about it. But yeah, bro, what kinds of stuff would you like to see if people sent, viewers send stuff? What would you like to see? What would you like to get?
What do you mean?
I know that you really like the Code Red Mountain Dew. What other stuff would you like to receive?
I don't know, bro. It's not really about me nowadays. It's about the youth, you know what I mean? What the youth can get. I mean, maybe a better spoke for it, or a better platform to speak for them, you know what I mean?
For sure, bro.
You know, not saying the parents are doing what they do, you know what I'm saying? But a better platform in school. And the judicial system. Hey.
Where'd you sleep last night, bro?
Right there at the house. How did you sleep? Yeah. I got insomnia, bro. I'm diagnosed with insomnia.
With what?
Insomnia.
Or insomnia. I feel it, bro.
Even if I wasn't using methamphetamine, right? I mean, I haven't lately. I've been doing other stuff, right? But I'll still be up. I mean, sometimes using the methamphetamine, what it does is amps my body up, and I get hella up for 2-3 days, and boom, I crack. And if I did it, normally I'd be up 6-7 days.
Hey, bro, how does it make you feel when you are on meth?
Well, it helps me.
Like you said, it makes you not sleep. What other things does it?
No, it don't make me not sleep. It's just, I'm gonna be awake with it or without it. You know what I'm saying?
Because
I have insomnia, bro.
Right.
What it does is it basically pumps my body up to get exhausted faster. You know what I'm saying? It stimulates it faster, my body quicker, than I go to sleep faster than just.
Hey, bro, what do you feel helps you the most to alleviate the pain that you go through, bro? From my
oxycodone, my all my medication the doctor gave me. Oxycodone, 20, 10 or 10. I took two. Right, my gabapentin, my muscle relaxer. I can't remember what it's called. My deloxycillin and my trazodone. That's what the doctor prescribed to me.
How many medications did they prescribe you a day?
No, that was my prescription right there. I just named all of them. Yeah.
That's all of them.
But I didn't give me. They only gave me two of them. They gave me my They didn't even give me my anti.
Hey, bro, if you don't mind talking about it, how was your life before homelessness and before all the issues, like, you know, the gangrene, the frostbite? How was it before?
Life, man.
Yeah, what kind of jobs did you have?
I don't even want to talk about my past.
You don't want to talk about it? Would you be okay with me doing another follow-up interview in the future, bro?
Yeah, bro.
And you're okay?
You fight me.
I'll fight you, dude.
When you got a track around me, you're
everywhere.
Yeah.
Probably. And lastly, bro, for people that don't, this is huge. How do you stay positive and motivated, bro?
Since I'm faking it, not really faking it, I'm not really all positive, you know what I'm saying, in my mind, I'm not really thinking positive, but I look at what's going on in the world, and I see progress in it, I see how people made advances, I think about the young ones, you know, like, if I need to think about something constructive, like the other day, here's a quick story, I was running by Davis, and I fell off, I forgot to have, I didn't have my back on, so I fell back, I was on the floor, on the ground, from 4 o'clock in the morning, all the way to 8:42. And if it wasn't for these two young men from Davis, what's up, Davis? They picked me up like that. They woke up me like this. They woke up like that, picked my dumb ass up off the ground and set me in my chair. I would have been on the ground still. So stuff like that, you know, it helps me. There's some good young people out there, man. The young ones, shit. It's their future, you know what I mean?
And hey, bro, do you have any fresh wounds being out here in the streets, in your legs?
No,
bro. Cause I was gonna say, like, you don't want to get it more infected.
No, it's not infected right now. It's infected, but it's not infected. You know what I mean? It's going through the process of cleaning. What I messed up on, it's supposed to have the wound back on it, but I left that prematurely.
It's gotta be a struggle for you, bro, to attain to it. You know, every day, right?
I'm told it's my fault, so I'm accepting responsibility for that. But right now, I'm just irritated. I'm dwelling on what just happened right now.
Hey, bro, would you be okay with me posting this on my YouTube channel?
Huh?
You'd be okay with me posting this on my YouTube channel, bro?
What's that?
My YouTube channel?
No, I don't know, but you already did that, did you?
I did, and you know what? I already asked you the question, too, dude. I already asked you the question. Anyway, bro, I appreciate your time. And, bro, once again, thank you, man.
For sure.
It means a lot, bro. And
thank you.
There's a lot of people that are wanting to make sure that you're staying up, that you're motivated. I'm going to show you right now some of the comments, bro, that they made on your first video. Thank you, bro.
All right.